All right, so we have here today is the Tex XL Wheeler Bag from Vito Pro Pack with the V-Swap. This is one of the brand new bags that was put out at AHR Las Vegas this year. And right now I have it here. I've been using it for a while, and we're going to take a look inside and see all about this bag. So when you open the bag up, it's got two sides to it. This is going to be the front side, and you can see all the tools that it fits. Just plenty of pockets, plenty of room for everything and anything you need. This is how I outfitted the bag. You can outfit the bag exactly how you want. It's got front pockets in the front for you to put all those little tools that you don't use every day, but you gotta have. We all know how that is. But bag is very well made, and like I said, plenty of room. Very big. The telescoping on the top is also very good, very sturdy, comes up and down very easily and locks in with great. It's got two handles on the side where you can strap it up if you need to carry it up somewhere and you know you want to put a rope or something on it, you can do that as well. Like I said, all the tools fit very nicely inside. The pockets are very well made, very long elastic, so you can pull them in case you need to put them in. But for right now, this is all that I really need. Pretty much my wrenches, my nut drivers that are inside there, my cutters, which is what I work with. And one thing I like is that it's got room holding this wrench, which I use a lot on flashometers. So that's very good for me. And like I said, fits very effortlessly. I'm having a little trouble here, but I mean, you get the picture. I mean, it slides right in. So loving the bag, loving the space, and it's a rollaway. So that's something that I've always wanted inside a bag. Now we're going to turn this puppy around. A lot of stuff in there, but very well worth it. The back, as you can see here, we're going to open that up. And what I use the back portion of this for is for my power tools. Whatever power tools that I'm going to be using is what I like to have back here. So plenty of room in the back for you to put. Look what I'm taking out. I'm taking out my impact driver here. I'm taking out my light, and I'm taking out my bandsaw. So right now, as you can see, plenty of room there in the back that you can put in. All my attachments for the drills are on there as well. As you can see, it's got a zipper there as well for you to put other pieces that you may need as well. So this is actually a very good bag. It's got a lot of room in the back, but you do have the option of also bringing in a V-swap in, as you can see right here. So the V-swap goes in very effortlessly, very nice, and bam, that's it, you're done. So you have another tray of tools to put in case you don't want to put power tools in there. You can put other hand tools inside, or if you need to, maybe some electrical equipment or some HVAC equipment. You can put all that stuff on right here on this side of the bag. So that's another option you have along with putting power tools. Like I said, me, I take that part out. I like to use this for power tools. It's just the way that I wanted to outfit and the way I wanted to use the bag. So I can put all my stuff back inside without a problem. And this is mostly what I like to use this bag for, is because it has the option to put in, you know, my power tools inside. Now, you don't have to use just these power tools. There are other power tools that you can use just in case. Like I said, we got the attachments there as well. But you do have options. The bag has plenty of space. It's very well made. Just like anything with Vito. So you got options with this bag to be able to outfit it the way that you want to outfit it in. So for me, there, like I said, there are different options. You don't have to use just this option I'm looking for. You can take these power tools out and you can put in some other power tools. In this case, we're going to put in some different ones in just to show you the versatility of the bag and how much room is in here. We did put in some pretty big tools in here. Right now, we're going to put in maybe your cutter, or you can put in your Uponor tool. And obviously, you know you're going to need that drill because you're going to have to strap up some pipe somewhere. So you got your drill in there. You got your light in there. And you still have, even with that, some plenty of space in that bag to put in some more power tools if need be. So definitely what I like about the bag is having the option of putting power tools, eliminating having to carry another set of either boxes or another set of buckets. You can use this bag right here to carry your power tools in the back and carry your tools in the front. It just makes perfect sense.